Good. But can you give me a little time? I'm doing something. Explain the reason as to why you are postponing it. That's good. Create interest in them. Good, great work. In ACT, Mr. Nagesh knows very well. When I talk about analysis of any performance, we're not supposed to say anything negative in the first. We always talk positive. What was good in you? What is nice about you? Then finally say, can we make these modifications? Bring that later. Corrections can be brought later. I learnt it from Peter Drucker himself. He taught us how to speak. And he would be criticizing us to the bones, in fact. But first of all, mention 2-3 good things that we did. So that creation of interest in the person, moment somebody comes to you, jump on him and say, not worth it. You lose interest and second time you don't go. It happens from LKG class onwards. As a teacher, I have seen, when the teacher goes into the campus, one little child somewhere near the corner is drinking water from the tap. She runs all the way, huffs and puffs and comes and says, good morning, miss. What is she trying to say? Why she runs all the way to say good morning? And the teacher says, good morning, dear. She'll be so happy. Nothing else is wanted. She just goes away. Second time also the child goes. If the teacher does not respond second day also, third day she won't come. She would respond. Showing interest is showing that I like you so much. That sparing of giving your interest is also important. Giving recognition. When somebody does good, we stand up and applaud. Very great job. Giving recognition is most important. If you don't recognize people at the right time, we are losing jewels. I tell you, if that particular moment you are not appreciated and put into proper ways, you are destroyed. Recognition. I can go on giving stories like that, any number of stories. Dante Rossetti. I don't have heard of him. One of the greatest painter of the Italian Renaissance period. Greatest painter. He was about to go for a lecture elsewhere. His secretary came and said, sir, somebody is waiting for you. For last 3 months he is coming every day. He wants to meet you for 2 minutes. Sir, no, I am busy. Sir, 2 minutes. 3 months he is coming. Okay, send him in. One middle-aged man came inside. He said, I have only 5 minutes for you. Don't spend much time. No, sir. 2 minutes only. He took out one set of paintings and said, can you have a look at them? Dante had stood up already. While standing, he looked at this painting, nothing great about them, very ordinary paintings. He didn't want to insult him. He said, okay, fair, but lot of effort has to go on to become good. Make an effort, okay? He is about to go. Then the old man said, sir, one more set of drawings. He took out one more set of drawings and the moment Dante saw that, he sat down. Over his spectacles, looked carefully, said, genius, genius work, extraordinary. Whose paintings are they? Your son made them? The old man had tears in his eyes and said, no, sir, the second set of paintings I gave you were made by me 20 years ago. And the first set I showed you were made by me recently. He said, what happened to you? Such a classic painter, extraordinary painter that you were 20 years ago, why did you not become a great artist? Why you lost that? He said, the only problem was I did not find Dante Rossetti at that time. If Dante Rossetti had met me and said, you are going to be a great painter, I would have been a great painter myself. But nobody recognized me at that time. Giving recognition is most important. And finally, my friend, giving is receiving also. We should know that. When you give, you get back 10 times more. I have a classic real example of mine. My friend who was with me in Harvard, he became a doctor. He is in Ranchi. Very, very socially committed fellow. He's a good doctor. He keeps 2 mobiles. You know, everywhere in Ranchi, the number is hammered on the trees also. People do it. He doesn't do it. That mobile number is given to everybody in the city. That mobile number should be called only when it is critical. Other mobile is for other use. Moment it rings and that phone means some emergency case. He has told him he doesn't take money for it. He does lot of service free. He's become like God in Ranchi. Moment this phone rings, he says, what is the address? Tell me, where is the address? He just drives and goes there and saves lives. He saves hundreds of them. He told me an incident. One day he had gone to some place to see an old person. He treated him and he came back. Suddenly this phone rang. One lady was in distress. Doctor, please come. I don't know, my son is not able to breathe. Less little fellow, 2-year-old fellow, not breathing. Come immediately. Where is the house? She gave the address. Said, okay, I'm coming there. He asked an old man how to go to that place. He said, very simple, sir. You can go the same road and go further 4 kilometers to join the main road, ring road. I don't have time. Then you can go shortcut here. There's one road, not very good, but go there. There is some little depression there. You cross that, you join the main road. You can go there in just 2 minutes. He took the shortcut route. It happens to us. He went to the road and he could see the highway there. But somebody had dug up between the two. And he can't go. He just can't go there. He suddenly saw the right side that somebody, JCB was there. Huge JCB was there. He told him, can you fill some little mud? I'll go on this side. No, sir, I'm busy, he said. Please, Baba, some child is in distress. Okay, wait a minute, sir. He brought his JCB and huge mounds of soil, put it there, hammered it nicely, and just enough for the car to go. He also pushed it. Car went on the road. He went to the house. The child had swallowed a coin. Had stuck there. This fellow went there, put the child upside down, hammered it, removed it, and child started breathing. If he had gone 10 minutes later, the child would not have survived. The mother was grateful and touched his feet. Your God, and all kinds of things happened. He came back to his house. After 3 days, he was going on the same ring road, suddenly saw the same JCB. That day, he had no time to thank that old young man who had helped him to put. He stopped his car just to thank that man, because you helped me, I could reach and save a life. He got down from the car and the JCB fellow saw. He came running. And I think of it, I get tears in my eyes. My friend told me, that fellow came running on the road and fell flat on the road, prostrated, and touched the feet of the doctor. Actually, doctor wanted to thank him. And the young boy was crying uncontrollably. He said, why are you crying, man? I came to thank you. Sir, I should thank you, sir. It was my child. I did not know. When I went back home, doctor was telling me, young man helped me with the JCB to fill the soil there, otherwise I would not have come here earlier. I never knew, sir, when I was filling soil, you are rushing there to save my child's life. I didn't know myself. And doctor said, remember, when you give somebody, you get 10 times more from others. That's a beautiful joy of giving. I conclude my talk with another lovely story, which perhaps he has heard. I have written about it. This incident happened in Chennai. I wrote it about 15 years ago. I have received more than 20,000 mails telling me that the story has changed their life. My friend was an officer in, manager in Hewlett Packard in Madras. It happened in his house. One day I was reading the newspaper on a Saturday morning. The IT people are smarter only on Saturday and Sunday. He was reading the paper leisurely and his wife came and told him, how long do you read newspaper? Stop of it. Stop it. Look at your darling daughter. What is your darling daughter doing? This happens in every house. When the son or the daughter does something good, both father and mother say, my son, my daughter. If they do something stupid, mother says, look at your son. Huh? The moment you say your son, there is some problem. The moment he heard his wife saying, look at your darling daughter, he thought something is wrong. He saw the little 6-year-old was crying. He tried to find out why she was crying. He could make out easily. The mother was forcing the child to eat curd rice, and child hates curd rice. His mother was forcing. The child was crying. This man kept the paper down, went and sat next to the child, put his arms around the shoulder of the child, said, Amma, for my sake, eat 2 spoons. If you don't eat rice, your Amma will scold me. The child, children are very intelligent these days. Child said, not only 2 spoons, Papa, I eat the entire bowl of rice, but will you give me what I want? They know when to put the hook at the right time. We think children are innocent, they are very, very smart. And father was in a generous mood. Yes, I'll give anything you want, child. Child did not eat, looked at the mother. Amma was angry, she was still watching her. The child said, Amma, you should also promise, then I'll eat. Mother said, first eat, then I'll get you what you want. The child wiped the tears, ate the entire bowl of rice. Father was feeling the agony of the child. Child does not like curd rice. Poor thing wants something, I don't know what she wants, and for the sake of eating it. Child finished eating, drank water, washed their hands and legs, came back. Father was sitting on the sofa. She jumped on the father's lap, put her little arms around the father's neck. Children can be very sweet when they want something, you know. Put her arms around the father's neck and sweetly asked, Papa, can you give me what I want now? Father's heart sank. In a generous mood, he had given her a blank check and then said, Amma, don't ask for big things. Your father is not a rich man. Ask for cheap things. I'll definitely give you. It's very cheap, Papa. Then ask. Child became conscious that everybody in the room is watching her. Who are there in the room? Father, mother, and mother's mother, grandmother. Child came still close to the father's ears and whispered, "Is tomorrow Sunday?" He said, "Yes, tomorrow is Sunday." Then, "Don't hesitate, child. Ask what you want. I'll get you." Then child said, "Appa, then can you take me to the barber's place and get my head shaved?" Father felt as though he put his hand in a 230 volt socket. Mother and grandmother jumped up 3 feet in the air and said, "What nonsense is that? Huh? Girl shaving her head? Not allowed. Inauspicious. Not allowed." Father said, "Why do you want to shave?" "I don't tell you, but I want to shave my head." "Why do you want to shave head?" Child is not telling, but she wants to shave her head. Father said, "Sorry, I'll not do it." Then first reasoned out, "Such a lovely face you have got, big eyes, long hair, looks so nice. Girl with a shaven head will look all right." "No, nice or not, but I want to shave my head." The father said, "Sorry, I will not do it." Child started crying. Then told him, "Papa, other day you told me the story of Harishchandra and told me once you promised you should stick to it. 5 minutes ago you promised, and what I asked is not costly also, is very cheap." Father looked at the opposition party, mother and the mother-in-law, and then said, "Okay, child, I'll do it tomorrow." There must have been a Kurukshetra in the house that night. Next day morning, he took the child to the barber's place, got her head shaved. Child was so happy. Next day morning, child was ready to go to school. Please visualize how the child would look. 6-year-old girl, bright uniform, nice backpack, good water bottle, tiffin carrier, and shaven head. Father took the child in the car, drove her up to the school. Child got out of the car, went and stood near the gate of the school. He could not see her. "Go inside, go inside," father said. The girl said, "No, Papa, I'm waiting for my friend." "Who is that friend? I'll also see." This man waited in the car. A minute later, another car came behind this car. One little boy got out of that. Same uniform, similar backpack, similar water bottle, similar tiffin carrier, and same shaven head. This boy slowly went and started talking to that girl. This man was watching this girl and the boy, and then he wondered whether the school changed its uniform. Shaven head is a part of the uniform. At that time, one lady who was driving the car behind came out. She was crying. This man is not watching her at all. He was watching only the two children. She came and asked, "Sir, is that girl your daughter?" He said, "Yeah, she is my daughter." She said, "She is not a daughter, sir. I don't know for how many births you prayed God to get an angel as your daughter. God has been kind to you, blessed you with an angel-like daughter. You are very fortunate." He's still not listening to her. "Yes, that fellow is your son?" "Yes." "Yeah," she said. "Very interesting, you know. On Saturday, my daughter insisted that she should shave her head. And she has come today like this. And I see your son also has shaved his head. Why?" The lady who was crying could not control herself. She sat down and started sobbing. Then he looked at her and said, "What happened, ma'am? Did I say anything wrong?" He said, "Nothing, sir." Then she said, "My son has not shaved his head, sir. My son is suffering from blood cancer for the last 2 years. He is my only born. And doctors tell me he is like a guest. He can get up and walk anytime. Keep him like a guest. 6 months ago, we started chemotherapy treatment for him. He lost hair on his head. Become so shrunken, no energy in his body. I told you, your daughter is like a angel. She comes to our house every week, peps up the spirit of my son. Last Friday she came. 'Come to school on Monday,' she told my son. My son said, 'I can't come, I can't write.' 'Don't worry, I'll write for you.' Then he said, 'No, I can't come. Children laugh at me, you know.' Know what your little daughter did? Put her little palm on the palm of my son and said, 'I'll promise you, nobody would laugh at you. I don't mind even if they laugh at me, but I don't want them to laugh at you. Come Monday, nobody will laugh at you.' Believing your daughter, my son has come to school for the first time. As I was coming here, when I saw your daughter near the gate with a shaven head, I could instantly make out that this is the sacrifice that your daughter made for the sake of my son. That's why I told you, she is not a child, she is an angel." At that time, the father realized why the girl wanted to shave her head. He held his face in the palm of his hand and cried, "Amma, in this birth, you are born as my daughter. In my next birth, don't be born as my daughter. born me as my mother and teach me how to love and care others without expecting anything from them. We were all like that only, we were small children. Very small children were like that only. Then one day mother told, I put halwa in the lunch box, don't give it to everybody. I sat separately, ate and came back. Somebody told, don't give your notes to him, he also get the same marks, don't give it. Somebody said, don't tell your brother, he'll ask for property. We started becoming more selfish, more selfish, more selfish. The world has become very bad because we have become selfish. The moment there is a desire to give, the boundaries disappear. I become richer, I become successful, I become happy. In fact, great man Emerson, Ralph Waldo Emerson says, your life success is measured by the number of people smile by remembering your name. He also says, only when, even if one life breathes easier because you lived, your life is successful. So success of my life is not measured by my bank balance, measured by the kind of material things that I accumulate. Not that, it doesn't mean I should renounce everything, become a sannyasi. No. Live happily, earn ethically, no problem. But when the time comes when you find tears in the eyes of the fellow sitting next to you, I must have that kind of humanity to take up my handkerchief and wipe his tears, ask, can I do something for you? That desire to give will define the quality of our life. Thank you so much. Thank you. Any questions, suggestions, modifications, corrections?
Why is that realization not there? And you said that Mother Teresa said that they are my God. How do you inculcate this? Say that God is their only.
I can tell you very quickly, sir, is a very my thesis, my favorite thesis is that why have we come to this stage where we have virtually come to worship material benefits? Even giving a diamond-studded kirita to Venkateshwara is also a material gift. God does not want kirita. In fact, his creation is his. What extra you are giving? He wants your unconditional love and devotion. But I still feel I am a great devotee by giving a kirita tangible. Because ever since human beings came on this planet Earth, there have been transitions. Each era of human existence throws up a role model. And people during that time start living up to the model. Take the Veda Kala, Upanishad Kala. Who are the role model society at that time? Rishis. They did not live in the cities. They live in the banks of the river, deep in the forest. But kings and princes went to sit at their feet and learn. Knowledge was respected. Caste was not there. Life was so beautiful. A Kaushika, a Kshatriya, could take penance and become Rishi Vishwamitra, Maharshi. That means the boundaries were not rigid. You could become anything. Most of the kings became rishis. Janaka was a king and became a maharshi. That means it was not caste. You could become. At that time, the only icon was a rishi. Everybody wanted to be a rishi. That means wisdom was respected. Further coming to the Indian history, Mahabharata time, who are the heroes of Mahabharata? Bhishma, Dronacharya, Arjuna, Bhima, Karna, all warriors, great warriors. Remember, at that time, Krishna Dvaipayana, Veda Vyasa was also there. What is the tribal boy Ekalavya is hoping to become? He is not trying to be Veda Vyasa, he wants to be like Arjuna. That means the role model at that time had shifted from, changed from wisdom to bravery. Everybody wanted to be a brave man. Even Kripacharya, a Brahmin, wanted to fight in the war. Dronacharya fought in the war. He did not teach Upanishad to them. That means wisdom gave way to bravery. Why so far in human history? Before independence, who were our role models? Gandhi, Patel, Bhagat Singh, Rajguru, Sukhdev, Patriotism was a value at that time. It was of great value. Every primary school taught children Vande Mataram, and everybody wanted to be a freedom fighter. Patriotism was a value before independence. Unfortunately or fortunately, after independence, a rich man has become a role model. So as I told you, people living during that time want to emulate this model. They want to be as rich as possible, as quickly as possible, and at any cost. So this last is a dangerous thing. If I want to be rich at any cost, it is normally at the cost of values. And people who donate, that means I think of only material, nothing else. I want to be rich. And how do I show that I am rich? I have to demonstrate my richness. If I can give you 32 crores, a diamond-studded kirita to Venkateshwara, I must be having at least 320 crores with me. Is it not right? The kind of flamboyancy of show-off comes because I even think of giving in terms of money only. Because my mind is so rigid in materialistic world, it will not remain.